Hi guys! I'm exploring new hobbies and I got this latch-hooking kit. I have never done these before, so let's see this one. I have started it already, however, so... So it comes with this big mesh fabric. It's pretty rough. When I work on it, sometimes it scratches hands. Be careful with that. A lot of pre-cut yarn and instructions. However, I never really followed the instructions given here. I followed instructions that I watched on YouTube. I found those to be easier to follow. You are supposed to start at one corner and just go in lines. I decided that I will start with this wool first, and then later I will do the second one. When I got this kit, I really thought that it's only gonna take a few hours for a couple days, and I would be done. Well, unfortunately that was not the case. It really is a very slow process. I think it's gonna take me at least 100 hours to finish this piece. The kit did not come with these latch hooks. These I got separately. Thanks Amazon for reviews. That's the only way I came to know if it doesn't come with them, and I was able to pick them up when I was getting this box. Yeah, and they just little latches that open and close very easily. So the way I do this is in batches of 10. That's easier for me. So. These blue squares are the same over here. So I have finished the first one and I'm on the second one, row number 8. Yeah, 8, 9, 10, 8. I do it in batches of 10 and lay them out on my thigh. It just makes it much easier when I already have the colors sorted out and arranged for me to just do the 10 pieces and then do the next batch after that. So here we need 2 black, dye, 5 dark gray, and it's very important that you already initially figure out the right colors, because otherwise you might run out of certain colors and that would really not end up well. Imagine finishing half of this large project and understanding later that you just didn't pick the right colors. That is really not gonna end up good. Okay, 5 dark gray, 2 medium gray. I've come up with terms for these colors. And 1 dark gray again. Okay, so I have them all right over here on my thigh in order. That way I can finish these 10 without thinking, and then I can move on to the next one. Alright, so we are all set up now. Let me show you how it's done. So first we take a thread and loop it up right in half. Then we keep it through the needle and put it in the loop that we want to put the stitch in. As we come back and this latch closes, we have to keep these two ends in the latch. This way, once we pull it back, it's gonna come right through. Then we just need to tug it a little bit to make it nice and fast. And we continue with the next one. Again, loop, put it through the needle. Grab the ends and pull it through. And we have it easy because all of the threads we have already arranged in the order. Otherwise it takes much more time to every time find yourself in the map of the colors and get the right color. But we already have them lined up for the first 10 stitches. up, loop it through, grab the ends, pull it through. Sometimes the ends don't come up equal on both sides, and I try to tug on the shorter one more than the longer one. That usually helps getting them the same length. Like so, this one's slightly shorter, I give that one a little bigger tug. Here we go. Six done. So you can imagine how slow this process is. And in half, put it through the needle, get it in your hole, catch the ends, and pull it through. Another little thing is that I find that in the middle, you should twist the needle so that the threads come through properly. See here, I twist the needle and then pull the threads. Otherwise, they do not quite come each on their own side. Sometimes they can be crisscrossed, and that can be a little bit, I don't know. It's probably not a big deal, but I really don't like that. So we're done with our pen. And I'll probably run a time lapse on the rest of them. Let's see how fast that goes. Also see why it's important to start from the bottom up, because this way we have nothing in our way. We can easily work on the next piece. If we do it on the side, then we have these little strands hanging over, and it kind of makes it a little more difficult. It's not doable. It's just not ideal, which is why they write it on the back to start from the bottom. But I feel like that's quite boring, and especially on such a large project. I could not wait till I see the picture, so I decided to do this work first. So I guess at some point I will run into that issue where I'll have to work with this edge hanging over, but I'll make it work. I got two of these latch hooks, and I really thought that my kids can probably help me. And one of them was interested, a 7-year-old. And he did this one over here. It's a little messy right now. But I don't really think it's for kids that are not extremely patient, because so the way he worded it was, it looks easy and fun, but it's hard and I hate it. So there you go. If your kid is not very patient, they probably will not enjoy this. So yeah, let's keep on going. So this is where I'm at. I got three rows in of 70, that's 210, and then another of 10, so that's 220, and it took me almost 2 hours. So yeah, it's gonna be a slow process. Do you think it's worth it though? I mean, like, you would think that something similar might be available in Walmart for $15, right? So I hope it's not. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked the video, subscribe, and you might see me posting more fun craft ideas that I will be trying out. I have some ideas that I might post in the future. I will also post some updates on how I'm doing with this. How long do you think it's going to take me? I'm really hoping that I could finish it within a month, but I really don't know if I'll have the patience to continue at the same speed that I've been going at. So we'll see. Alright, thank you and bye bye.